Welcome, 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 guys. If you are just joining this stream, you're welcome. My name is Jeff Imalaba, and I'm with No Limit Markets. And today we'll be analyzing the entire financial market, including the Forex futures and then the crypto market, especially the crypto. So we're looking focused primarily on the futures on the Forex market and then the crypto markets. So if this is your first time you're joining this live stream, again, I want to welcome you to this stream. Please make sure to smash the subscribe button and, of course, hit the notification button as well so that you can have access to all our content. We'll be doing this every day from 7 a.m. Eastern Standard Time to 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. So that will give you opportunity to see what we'll look at when we analyze the entire market and how you guys can take advantage of that as well. Please take a moment to join our executive chat room. This is where we get to manage all our trades, and then we'll connect with other traders from across the world. While we are on that, let me quickly add this to our banner so that you guys can see what we are looking at now. Just that will give us all access to the same feature of what we are looking at in the market right now in a bit. So hopefully you guys can see that, and then you can also have access to the chat room itself. So please, like I said, take a moment to join our the executive chat room. This is where we'll get to manage all our trades, and then we'll connect with other traders from around the world. So our trading style, yes, what is our trading style? So our trading style basically mirrors the market makers or the big dogs, those who control the markets. It's simply because you understand that the Forex market is over a $5 trillion a day market. That's not a small amount of liquidity that flows in this market. So you have a lot of big players that control this market. You have to understand that they're designed to trick you. And once you can understand those factors, then you know that you are going to be in good hands. So we look at the overall picture of the market, and then we identify stop horn zones. We just saw one of the stop horn zones playing right now before us. So you guys will see what we're talking about. So if you want protection of your funds and you want to be successful in this market consistently in the near term, the medium term, and over the long term, then you're in the right place, friends. You're in the right place. That's very important. Please, trade opportunities do not occur every day. That's very important. Every day, you will not have the opportunity you will have to take a trade that will not go against you. So, of course, it's not the frequency of the trade that matters. Instead, it's the accuracy and the quality of the trades. But if you're looking for a quick way to throw your money away, or you want to join those 90% of traders who lose money all the time, then this is not the channel for you. So please feel free to ask your questions, or share your chat with us what you want to have analyzed. And we will do that. We'll spend the time to analyze those for you. Again, like I said, we'll do this every day from 7 a.m. to 7 a.m. Eastern Standard Time to 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time daily. Again, if this is your first time, make sure to hit the subscribe button, subscribe to our channel, and then hit the notification button as well. Before I get started, let me quickly do this, guys. Just give me a minute now so that we can have this on our screen. If you're watching, let me know where you're watching in the world. You can have ask your questions, and then we can be able to address that for you as well. So just in a few minutes now, I'll be able to connect this. Give me just 1 minute. Here we go. Okay, let's go, guys. Let's go. So today is 15th of June, so we're looking at a deep dive. We'll take a deep dive into the entire market, from the Forex to the crypto market, how we're able to, chunk out consistent returns on investment from this market. So let me get started again right now by sharing my screen, and then you guys can take you guys behind the scene, and then so hopefully you all can see. Okay, yeah. So yes, we're good now. Yeah. So hopefully you guys can see the chart here. So we're looking at, first of all, today we're looking at the we're gonna analyze the entire market. This is the dollar Swiss franc, and just to see what's going on here. So we notice here that we have this is a downtrending market, and it's been falling consistently. We can see that how it bounced off the 50. The 200 EMA here on the daily charts, and then we can see the market trying to retest that same position again. for a continuous downtrending pattern. There's nothing yet that indicates a buy, so you might want to stay out of this market if you are considering looking at taking a place here. I mean, from the 4-hour chart time frame, the daily chart too, we are in almost a no man's land. So if you've been following me for a while, you know what we mean by no man's land, almost a position of inactivity. However, we observe some bullish divergence creeping in here in this market. So that can be a potential move. However, you still have some activities below this line, which can trigger either direction movement. So you want to be cautious about this. I would say it's a no trade for now, especially from the 4-hour chart that basically throw a bit more calmness to the volatilities of the 4 hours. So this is the trade that you guys need to understand what's going on. This is the trade we're taking. We want to help you guys understand what's happening here in this trade so that you will see how powerful this is. So first of all, let me kill this a little bit, make this much more cool. So we've seen divergence pulling in into the daily chart. This is the daily chart. And then you can see that's happening here. Now, so we have this, we've been selling, we've sold for about a couple of days now, we've made monies with this, and then we stood out this market. And again, this morning, we wanted to wait for the big players or the market makers to get involved in this market. And again, today they are in. How would you know? Because they go after stop on zones. Most times, new traders don't understand what we mean by stop on zones. And then they just think that just because they see what they see in the market, they're just going to go in and then take a trade. That's not the way the market works. The market is designed to trick you. Your goal is to be able to identify those trick zones and then stay out of them. What you understand is that once the stop on zones are triggered, or the market, the big players coming with the stop on zones, they will hardly ever go and test these levels again. So these levels you're seeing right now, what we're going to teach you is to understand how to wait, how to be patiently waiting for this reaction. It's called blood on the street. So you want to see those blood on the market. You want to see the market players going, and they're going aggressively. What they're trying to do is to take away all the small traders. You don't want to be among those small traders. You want to be among the big players. And once they're going actively, you want to wait. Once they are done, the market will hardly go and retest those levels. So if you look at the daily chart, we have two case scenarios. First, this market is going to come down all this way to test these levels, the 50 EMAs or even the 200 EMAs. So we have a huge potential here in this market. Our stop loss is within the 30 pips range, usually to about 50 pips. That's our stop loss zone. So we have an expectation of over 170 pips to the downside here, to even 200, and then a maximum of about 500 pips to the downside on this pair. So that's basically what we are looking at right now. And if you go to the 1-hour chart, you will see that the activities of the big dogs came in this morning, or the market makers. That's what you can see happening. So if we've joined this stream earlier, would have taken this trade from here. I would have given you guys the go. This is what we do in our premium room. So because we know, we expect this to happen before. Once you see this move, once we identify this move, we know that this level will never be tested anymore. This level you see here would rarely be tested, of course, unless the market is trying to do a double top at that level. It will hardly be tested today. So and that's just how the market plays. So you guys are fortunate to see this happening live in front of us. So guys, the Swiss franc Japanese yen is a sell on our watch. As you can see, we are live on that trade. So this has a huge potential to the downside. One thing you learn to be with us here is that you learn to understand how to go in with peace of mind and staying on the trade. You have, so you're risking about, say, 1 to 100. So your risk level is extremely low, because that's what we teach you here, how to conserve and preserve your funds. So you don't want to be taking trades that will, you know, you're going in for a trade just to try to lose your funds. That's not the way we trade here. So guys, just give me a second. Let me make sure I'm monitoring everybody's comments as well, just to see if you are leaving a comment or a question, and then I can be able to see what's going on over there as well. Okay, just a minute, guys. Just want to be sure that's okay. Let's see. Just want to be sure. So that's it for the Swiss franc, the Swiss franc right now. So as I said before, it's live. You guys can. I'm sorry, guys. So you guys can leave your questions, and then we'll be able to monitor your questions as well as they pop in. Okay. So I think that makes it clear. Now, so let's go to the next. We're looking at the pound dollar pair right now. Okay. So with this. This looks like a potential. Let's look at this carefully. I think the market is actually, it's inconsistent at the top levels there. We've seen a lot of sell orders coming, so the sell place, but it's not been extremely decisive. This has not been a very decisive move. The market tested this levels a couple of times when divergence crept in. But it's been a sell, but it's not been consistent. I think the market ran into the news during the past week, and that's created this move for dollar strengthening, and then again the pound kicked in as well. And so I would say for now on this pair, you want to be very cautious because there's a lot of chatter here, and it has spanned for a couple of days. This likely for me means that the upside might still continue if you're not careful with this pair. So please, if you are trying to trade the pound pair, I would say be careful. It doesn't look like a potential move that we'll want to take right now. So that's for the pound. So let's go to the euro. Let's see what's going on with the euro right now. So for the euro, this is the euro, the daily chart as well. Euro USD still indecisive here. So we still have some upside. We still have some, as you guys can see here, we still have some room to the upside for this part, this level to be tested. This level was tested the last time. Hold on, guys. Let me just take this down. The last time we got a test of these levels was on the January 6th. So we likely would have a test of this level. That's basically how the market works. And then it had some chatter here. So we want to see decisive move to the upside. And then that will let us know that indeed the market is actually ready to head south. So on the 4 hour where we'll make our decision making process from. So it's not, of course, we're not going in this trade right now. Instead, we'll wait for two things to happen. So the trade is not decisive, it's not clear cut, and as such we would not we're not going on this trade. So there are three major trading patterns. So we either of the two patterns are very consistent, and then so the third one usually occurs in a while, but these two of our patterns play out almost on a daily, almost on a regular basis. So for Euro USD, I would say stand down. There's nothing going on there as well. Dollar CAD, the buying pair. We've been buying this pair for a while now. You can see this accumulation phase. So you can see that happening in the market. We've been buying this, and then though you guys are just joining now, we've made profits a couple of times buying this pair. It's so consistent. You can see this behavior, this pattern of the market coming in here, and then this whole accumulation phase indicates the buying levels. Right now, is it a time to go into buy? I doubt it, because you're entering late. The goal, when we trade this market, our goal is that once we go in on the market at a level that is consistent, we enter when this move ends. You can see this kind of a move. When this move come in, you know that the big dogs are in this market, and that move is what we'll go in, and we stay below this level and we'll just let it ride. So we break down our entry levels into two levels. You have the first initial level for a TP1 level. A TP2 is going to run wild. So this pair is going to run wild. Of course, we see that the break beyond this is great. I would say if you still are interested in going into this pair, wait for it to retrace back to this level. And then, of course, we'll be monitoring that. But the key thing is that you want to get in. You want to be an early bird. That's just the word I'm trying to get for you guys. You want to be an early bird. There are still other opportunities that will come in this pair, so monitor it. Our second, so once we meet, if you miss the first, our first entry, which is our first critical trading pattern, the second pattern confirms the move to the upside or the downside. So we're going to wait for that second pattern to play out. Once it plays out, you guys will get a green light from us to go in for the trade. Again, guys, if you have any questions, please make sure to leave your questions or your comments, and then we'll be able to trash this. Australian dollar, there's no point in looking at this. There's nothing happening here. It's just flat out. There's nothing going on there from that pair. Looking at the euro and the pound, still a lot of choppiness in the market. So if you notice this, a lot of choppiness have been in the market for weeks. So you want to be cautious when you trade. You don't want to just go in and trade based on a whim or based on your feelings. No, this is not a market of feelings. If, as a matter of fact, you want to do opposite to what the market is showing you. That's how you become successful over and over again, like the pair we are trading right now this morning. Most traders will get kicked out of the market because they've shown you, the market will show you a trick and then you fall for that trick. That's not how we trade. We'll teach you how to stay consistent. In our 25 years of industry experience, we know how these guys play this market, the tricks in the game. You know, it comes with years of experience, but we understand what they do. Euro, Australian dollar, let's look at this guy. What's going on with this pair? Is he exciting? Is he not exciting? What's happening, guys? What's happening here? So while we are on this, guys, let's hold up a little bit further so that we can, let me do this right now. Just give us one more minute. So again, if you are watching this stream live and you've not, so I'll give you guys who are watching this stream live an opportunity to go in on this trade. So I'll just give you guys a few minutes. You can see this trade is not going to go to retest that levels. So if you're wondering, let me just give you guys live right now. If you're watching, you can take a sell on the Swiss franc Japanese yen. Stop loss is 30 pips above your entry level. You want to take a stop loss of about 30 pips. Take profit, we'll be monitoring the take profit in our chat room. So make sure you join our free chat room. And we're also giving them access to this because they've seen us made monies on this pair over and over again in the past. So you also can take advantage. So I'm going to give you guys about next few minutes now to go in on that trade if you are watching this for the first time. Guys, so you have 2 minutes to place your trade. So let's go, guys. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. If you're still watching this now, let's do this. So you can just as you're watching this, you can put your entry as 12240. I think that will also be 41 or 42. That's where the price of the market is. So that's for your entry. Take profit one, I would say, let's just get that so for those who are new so that you guys will know how to place your levels. For take profit one, the critical levels will be, let's just do that right now so that we can help you guys make these trades. Take profit one levels. Let's see. This is 32 pips. Levels will be tested here for 45 pips. So that's one is for sure. So your level one will be, your TP one will be 121963. That level will be tested for refract before a rebounds or what have you. So TP2, just leave it open. So again, I said the TP1 will be at 45 pips minimum. We will just do 12196. So again, if you're watching this, you're fortunate to see this live happening live. This is this perfect trick in the market. It's designed to take away all the new small traders who don't understand what this market is doing. But we've been in this market for too long to be tricked by it. It's just a market game. Stop loss level. So again, it's just 30 pips away from your entry. Just so you guys watch me calculate this again, because the market is not going to go back that up to test it. It has done what it wants to do to take away everybody. So we want to put it, I think you got, well, depending on your broker, some brokers can, you know, because of their, what's it called? Their spreads, the market begins to go. So we want to put it at, it's about 40 pips because of over the level there. So I'll put it at 12280. So just put your stop loss at 12280. Again, you guys can see that already, we are in profit already. We'll monitor this trade. Make sure you join our chat room, because that's where we monitor these trades. So if anything changes, I will know, and then we'll just alert you on the chat room. Again, TP2 is open because this is a long. So the way we trade, guys, it's for the long term. It's for the long term. You don't just trade simple trades. We can take trades that will give us over 500 to 1,000 pips. But you have to know the right entry, guys. You have to know the right entry. Once you get in on the right entry, you're good to go. I think that's enough time for everyone who is still waiting to go in. You can see how it's coming into profit levels. It's going to just go in. Guys, it's just the way we trade. And once you understand this, you understand how to make money in the market consistently. Okay, well, let's get back to where we were. Hopefully, I'm giving you guys time to start making money with us. The first day you join us, the first day we're trading, the first day you guys are making money. Let's go, guys. Let's make this happen. Let's make this happen. Remember, if you're joining us now, hit the notification button. The goal here, in my plus 25 years, is to help you guys to understand how to be emotionally detached from this market. It's a very emotional market, but you want to trade with caution. If you want to protect your capital, then we'll do it here with you. You know, so let's look at this pair right now. So we're on the Euro AUD, nothing is happening here. We're going to take it quickly because we're almost 23 minutes. I want to have time to take your questions. We're almost 30 minutes into the chat. We have still a lot of chat to look at. Euro Swiss franc. Well, it has been beautiful for us for a while though, but let's see what's going on with this pair. Euro Swiss franc. This is an interesting pair, guys. So make sure you are in make sure you know what's going on. So on the daily chart, we see some activities below this level. This is interesting. The only reason we're gonna take a trigger on this level is when it plays out again for a retest on that level. So you can see from the daily chart, we are key at key support levels. We are key at key support levels, but we have some activities below these levels. So it's a tricky zone. You want to have confirmation. And from the 4-hour chart here, you guys can see that market is trying to come back again. So we need market to come back to this level and retest this level. A failure to cross that level with a tight stop loss, you know we are in the game. We're going to try and play that with this market. And then make sure again, like I said before, to join the chat room. So we have our premium, we're going to give you guys access to this as well. You know, you can see what we do in our premium signals, but you have access to making money with us. Even if you don't have cash to play right now, you can make money with the free alerts we give you guys. So this is still coming in down. I expect this is a very tight zone. You want to be extremely cautious here. You want the market to really move in the direction you want it to happen. And again, the timing of your market is very important. The timing is very critical. Timing in the US zone or the London time frame or the US time frame is very critical because there's a lot of activities, a lot of money moving into the market at that point in time. And so you want to be in the market when those market movements is happening. Let's go. Let's move to the next level. So we'll monitor this in our chat room. We'll keep you guys apprised of what's happening. So please make sure to join our free chat room. Connect with other traders. You will know what is happening. We'll let you know. We'll alert you basically when the timing is right. Euro Japanese yen. What's going on, Japanese yen? You're trying to kill the euro. So this is just it looks flat for now. The market is just not too sure. Let's see. The perfect entry came some weeks ago when we took this trade, but this is not the perfect entry right now. This was over here when we took this trade. This was the perfect entry. So you can imagine this. It never came back to test this level. And our TP1 was triggered. Our TP2 was, came out because when we moved stop loss to entry points, price came back to take that out. But that's because we still anticipated some other activities in the market. However, you guys will see how we trade this market and stay in this market for the long, long term. So Euro Yen is not a time to go in. It's actually we've been in before, and our members, made some profit from this level. So we still expect this level now to this high level to be retested and then for us to go in again later on. So on the pound Swiss franc, this is actually a no trade. There's nothing going on in this trade. We're just going to take this as a pass for us. Canadian dollar Japanese yen. Let's see this. Let's look at this. This is still just almost flat. Let's look at what's happening in the 4-hour chart. It's still a no trade for us right now. Still a no trade. This is not a trade right now. We're not going on this trade. So we just want it to play out. Again, like I told you, we have two play patterns, the first and then the second. So the second is not even playing out right now. So we're going to watch out for them and then see that. So the card Japanese yen, you've missed the entry. The key entry, the key critical entry has been missed. Everything right now happening is just, is a momentum. It's an AFP, The market is going through an AFP away from peak, which is this. You can see the peak levels here. So we're not, basically right now, this is not when we enter. We'll wait for the market to give us the entry. We'd like to go in when it's the entry is just brand new. We're the early bears. We're going with the early bears move. But we're going after a stop hunt zone has been clearly defined, because you cannot prevent a stop hunt zone from hitting you out of the market. The market players, they know that you set stop losses of 30, 40 pips. They already know that. So they can come in to kick you out of those market levels. But before you go in, you want to identify that, yes, they themselves are in the market, and they are selling or they are buying. Once their decision is clear and you see their levels entry and you see how they are playing the market, then, of course, you know that you are in the right direction. So for the pound yen, it's a no for us. The Australian dollar, New Zealand pay as well. This is still a no for us. Let's look at what's happening in the 4-hour chart from here. Still no activity here for us right now. We're monitoring this. We're still a potential retest of this high is coming up. And we can see in historical levels, you see how price came to test these levels a couple of times. This is not the first time. You can see it tested these levels back in April, and then again in May, a couple of times in May. So you see the test of these levels. We have it about the third time it's testing this level. So we're likely going to see a retest of this level and then wait for a potential stop hunt zone to be clearly defined before we can engage. Again, if you look at the daily, this market is actually in a no man's land here because the territory is falling. Yeah, we see that level. So we want to have confirmation. We have to have confirmation that, yes, this is a directional change on a sell. You can see even on the daily chart, it tested these levels a couple of times here. From here, you have the first test, second test, and then you have the third, the fourth, and now we are experiencing the fifth test levels. So you want to be careful here. You want the market to confirm what it's doing because you're playing the Australian dollar is a very strong pair as well. Same for the New Zealand dollar, but you want to know what. So right now, we'll stay on our hands, or we'll call what we call sit on your hands for now until the whole market is played out for us. Then we can see what we're doing. So for now, just take a hold on that pair. Don't do anything right now. That's the advice for you. I mean, you can do, you have the right to do whatever you want to, but the decision right now is that we want you guys to just stand down. Again, I said join our chat room. We'll manage our trades there, and then you guys will see what we're doing from the back end. And that was designed to protect your funds as well. For the Australian dollar, Canadian dollar pair, this is pretty flat. There's nothing going on here. Just don't bother yourself with this. It's pretty flat there. Let's look at the 4-hour chart as well. Still nothing is happening here. This is just, nothing is going on there. Just ignore that. So, again, guys, it's not the frequency of the trade that matters. Instead, it's the quality of your trades that matters. You don't want to go. This is a market as a $5 trillion a day market. You can make $10,000, $20,000 in a day in this market. However, you can lose that. So you want to be careful. You don't want to join the herds. You want to join the market makers, not the herds, guys. All right. This is the. You can see the choppiness here. You know we're not going to even analyze this. This is just a waste of our time. Let's move to the next pair. Australian dollar, Japanese yen. So we see some series of accumulation here happening, and then the market is also positioned for a sell. Let's look at the 4-hour chart to get some clarity to what's happening here. So this is interesting. The tricky zone is this level. We see how this level was tested. This is the top high level here that was initially triggered. This was triggered on May 10th. So we would like to see a retest of this level because this is a potential level the market is going to retest. And there with some stop hunt levels there, that's likely going to be interesting for us. So for now, we'll sit on our hands on that pair because there's nothing really happening until this level is triggered again. Then we'll know what's happening. This is our pair. You can see our pair. Oh, I think we have it open twice. So this is the pair we're trading. You understand how powerful this is as you get to work with us and you'll be with us for a while. You will see to understand how we trade. I'm sure if you guys are in this trade already, you're making money already. I can see that from here. It's just beginning. So we're going to stay on this trade, and you guys will see us do this trade. Again, we manage this trade on our chat room, so make sure to join our chat room so that you can have access to, if this market changes direction, we can see it. If the big dogs says no, this is done, because we don't control these markets. We can only give you a projection of what we think they're going to do. But if along the line they make a U-turn, we will see that U-turn displayed in the chat, and then we can tell you guys, stand down for this trade. I'm sure those of you who are watching this trade with us live now, you guys are already in profit. You can see how much you've started making our money already. We told you guys live here, because this is the market. We know how we trade this market, guys. And it's all about the pattern. They just don't be sucker in into the market showing you one thing. No, we know when they're coming in. We know how they come in. We know how they play. So you're already in profit if you're with us. And that's beautiful. Your first day with us, guys. Let's give a hands up for you guys. Those of you who are proud and who have who trust our analysis, guys. Big ups to you guys making money right now. Let's move on now. We're not going to sit down here. Let's move on. We have other things to do. Let's look at the pair right now. So Euro New Zealand pair dollar. This is a lot of choppiness. There's nothing happening here. Don't want to get sucked into this one. You know I'm not going to take that trade. You guys know already. If you've been with me for a while, you know how Jeff trades. So now let's move on to Euro dollar Canadian dollar pair. This pair right now, choppiness, a lot of choppiness. I think a lot of yesterday I was reading some news alerts, and a lot of fund managers across the world in the US here complained that for about 6 months the market has been choppy. So you want to have experience. This is not something I've just been doing for. I just woke up yesterday and say, hey, I can trade. No, Forex is not a game. It's not a game you play with. This is an interesting market. It's a $5 trillion a day market. You're going against the banks, so you don't want to go against the banks. You don't want to go against the sharks in the market. Instead, you want to swim with the sharks. You want to go with the sharks, flow with the tide. And so we wait for the tide to come in and then flow with the tide. Make it easier. Don't go against resistance. Follow the resistance. Or flow with the tide, basically. And that's what I'm trying to explain to you guys. Because your 1,000 is negligible in this market. It's almost nothing. Or even your $10,000 or your $50,000 or even $1 million is nothing in this market, guys. Because this market will take you in. All right, guys. So this has been a wonderful sale opportunity, but it's past you right now. Catchef has been, we traded this about four times because we have too many opportunities that came in this pair. So again, friend, if you're watching this for the first time, live on YouTube, on Facebook, make sure to join our, subscribe to our channel on YouTube. That's No Limit Markets. You will see, you will follow us, also follow our live chat room where we'll analyze, you know, this market. We'll manage these trades. We'll tell you when to go in. We'll tell you when we are in. Everything is happening in this chat, man. It's just amazing. New Zealand, Japanese yen. Let's go in and look at what's happening. Guys, we don't just trade a small move because it's moving. No, we don't trade that. You want to have a reason why you're trading. So if you are just looking at this and you're wondering, oh, it's moving, let's start selling. No, that's emotional. We don't trade emotional trades. We wait for the market to show what's happening. You want to go in and be 100%, I would say 100% because you don't know everything. I would say about 90 to 95% sure. That's how we trade. So if you are joining me and you're waiting to see trades there, if you are among our premium rooms and you're waiting to get signals every day, no, guys, no, we don't trade like that. We wait for the market to show us that exactly this is the direction, about 90 to 95% in that direction, then we are engaging. Other than that, we don't engage. You know, we don't engage. It doesn't make sense to trade your money, to risk your funds. It's hardened. You know, you work hard for your money, so don't put the money at risk just because the market is moving. All right, guys, so nothing is happening here for us. We're almost on the last lap right now. I'm ready to take your questions. We have a couple of minutes left before we end this live stream. So let's look at, I hope you guys, for the first day of joining us, have started making money. That's wonderful. We're happy for you guys as well. Okay, let's look at this pair right now. New Zealand dollar. Nothing is happening, guys. Just stand out of this pair. You have a lot of upside up potential here. You guys can leave your questions as well. And then if you want me to analyze a pair, I would gladly do that for you guys as well. Let's do this right now. Let's see what's happening on this pair. Pound pair. The pound. This is interesting. This interesting pair. So we have the key selling levels was this level here. You can see how price tested its levels when we had divergence here on the daily chart, and then again it's coming to that level. So guys, let me tell you one thing right now. This guy's pound is not a pair you play with. This pair is going to come back again to retest this level, so we're going to wait for this level to be tested. That is a fact. That, again, my friend, is a fact. This is going to be a four-time test on this level. Pound, pair, don't play. So you want to make sure to join our room, our chat, our executive room. It's called the executive. And then you see us. When we see this trade almost materializing, we will let you guys know on this trade. So right now, stand down on that pair. Wait for it to come to your level. Let's see what's happening here. Just a sec, guys. I have a custom, I have my custom, you know, chat I analyze, which is given to our premium members as well. So you guys will have access to this chatting tool that I'm using to look at the chat as well. So we see this, the daily chat here on New Zealand pair. This is interesting. Let's look at what's happening with it on the 4-hour chart as well. Okay, so it's choppy here right now. It's choppy, but it's a sell. So it's a sell direction, but we're not going to take a sell right here because you have your stop loss level is what define your entry levels as well. So you can see it's over 100 pips level. This market can go back 100 pips against. We don't want that to happen, never, to our traders. So our stop loss is usually within 30, maximum 50 pips on those pound pairs. And then you're looking at an upside potential of over 300, 400, 100, 500 pips to the downside in your favor. That's how you trade. You want to put it 1 to 5 in your favor, not 1 to 0.5 or 1 to 1. No. So at this level, we want to wait. It's right now from the daily chart as well as what I can see right happening to me. It's a key level. It's a key level. It's a very key sell level. Very, very key sell level. And that level is might be tested, though we still have some, you know, some traction at the top here, but we'll see what happens eventually as this pattern of this play out again. And then I would prefer to see a retest of that level and a failure to bounce above that level for us to engage. But again, everything will be clear. Once the market makers are moving in and then they move against that market move, then I would know for a fact that it's a sell. And then we'll tighten our stop loss levels. Again, like I told you guys before, you want to go with the market makers, not against them. You want to flow with the tide. Okay, let's just make this clear for us. New Zealand dollar pair. What's happening, guys? What's happening in New Zealand? This is a buy pattern playing out. We can see divergence coming in a couple of times now. That is clearly seen here. However, let's look at the 4-hour chart because that's your trigger level. Basically, we're not going to enter it right now because if you miss this entry level, you miss the entry level already. So you want to wait for this pair. You can't trade all pairs. You can't make money with all pairs. Sometimes you just let it go. You can see this is ours. This is exactly what we trade. This pair is exactly how we trade. So at this point in time, once we saw this, we would have taken a trade. I'll buy here. It doesn't matter. Forget about it. It's coming down. It doesn't matter. It's not going to go down. It's not going to go down, guys. So you want to set your stop loss. You see, 30 pips. It's not going to go down to that level, guys. That's how we trade. So it's already gone past our level right now. I think it happened, you know, late in the wee hours. So we'll just let it slide away. And we'll wait for a retest. So, guys, this is how you trade. Then you want to take this upside potential, 100 pips, even 200. Back to the same trigger level. That's how you trade. Nothing. You don't want to come in here at this level at a resistant level that anything can change. You can change direction here and go and hit your stop loss. Don't be emotional in this market, guys. So for now, you stand down. Join the executive chat room. That way, there's a link below this video to that chat room. That way, you will see and we'll monitor the trades for you guys. We're almost so. Let's quickly wrap up right now. If you have questions, guys, let me leave your questions right here and then we'll take those questions as well. New Zealand Swiss franc is right now on the daily. This is not a no trade for us, so we want to stand out of that trade. Let's go to the pound here. Okay, guys, let's see. So this is a lot of choppiness. You can see the choppiness here, so it's not a trade for us. We'll stand down on that pair. The ZAR, my very good friend, the US dollar ZAR. If you go to our Instagram page, you see how we make averagely $2,000, $3,000 on this pair daily. It was crazy, man. This pair is a nice, it's an exciting pair. So it has lost structure of late this year and last year, lost a lot of structure. So we saw this is a trigger entry for the sell, but you don't want to just take that sell. We want to be sure 100% what's happening in that pair. So let's go, let's do the analysis quickly on the daily. Okay, so we two things we're waiting for. Again, guys, this is a pair that can move 600 pips. I know this pair, I've traded it for 600 pips and 1,000 pips. That is its average daily range, which is, its ADR is about 300 to 600 pips. So it's a very exciting pair, but you want to get in at the right levels. The thing again, guys, the success in this market is your entry. If your entry is poor, then you're setting yourself up for failure. So you have to learn to be patient. You have to learn to be emotionally detached. And that's what we bring to the table with our years of experience. I told you over 25 years experience in this market, you know. So and when we come to play in this market, you want to be very, very cautious, guys. So wherever you're watching on Facebook, you're watching on YouTube, again, it's very important, guys. Always, always, always learn to be patient. This is not a market you go by just the fact of your feelings. Your feelings doesn't matter in this market. It's what the market is showing you that you want to do. So, guys, let's see. So that's for the ZAD. Nothing is happening right here. Gold, our very good friend Gold. This is the most perfect entry we had on Gold. This is a wonderful buy. At this level, you can go to the bank. Gold was just ridiculously insane. If you followed us at that point in time, even if you missed this entry level, because gold is heavy. So the entry level, this is now almost 2,000 pips, guys. So gold, I am usually more excited anticipating a buy on gold than a sell on gold. So sometimes you might be waiting and you say, why are we not taking all those trades? Gold is moving. No, guys, it's for you to enter at the point the market would... One good trade can change your life. Let me put it that simple. Let's just leave it like that. Let's just stop talking too much. One single good trade can actually change your life in this market. So, guys, you have to learn to be patient. So that's it for Forex. So we only have one trade running on the Forex market right now, and that is the Swiss franc Japanese yen. Hopefully, you guys are already making profits with that pair. Before I analyze Bitcoin, let me quickly go back to what we are looking at now. So this is our pair. You've seen already we're in profit levels. So we're not concerned about this. Is a 30 or 40 pips stop loss. It's nothing compared to your ability to make over 1,000, 2,000 pips. I mean, over this is our near-term take profit levels. I'm giving you guys the levels. So price will come to test this level, but if it changes, we will see that in this level. So this is about 100 and almost 200 pips here, 179 pips, while here's about 470 pips to the downside. These levels, it could get there, it may not get there. However, if the market changes direction, we will know, and then we'll alert you in our chat room. All right, let's go to gold now. I mean, to Bitcoin, guys. Bitcoin, Bitcoin, Bitcoin. Bitcoin has given us, last week alone, we did over 120% on our trades on Bitcoin. Last night, we made a couple of dollars on this pair. We sold this pair, made some quick 20% move, almost for, you know, almost $400-$500 came out from that last night. Bitcoin now. So Bitcoin has been in a ranging pattern right now. And then so you wait, if you are in the winners group, you always know that each of our trades, once we're going on Bitcoin, because of our years of experience trading other markets, we bring it to play when we trade Bitcoin. And then once we're going, it's almost surely going to go in our favor. Really goes against us when we trade. So right now, we would keep this. Nothing is happening this morning. Last night was when we took a trade on our members, you know, getting the alert for the sell. But this right now, nothing is happening right now. It's still choppy. We're still monitoring Bitcoin to see what's happening right now. So there's nothing really going on it. This is, you can see what happened in this market when divergence came in last night, and then we took the sell and make some quick money here, and then step out of the market. Of course, when it turned around, we saw that turning around, and then we left, you know, we stood out of the market. So it's because Bitcoin, the price hit a key level, which is a key resistance level. So that's what created that, that resistance of the sell. Of course, in the long term, Bitcoin is going to be an upside potential to the buy side. But right now, we would say it's, there is no activity right now. So again, if you've taken the trade with us for Swiss franc Japanese yen, that's the only pair we have running right now. That's how we trade, guys. You want to go in on a trade that is almost iron, we call it ironclad, you know, that is sure to move in your favor. Let me see if there's any comments here, questions. You guys have any questions? You have any comments? You can leave your questions. Let's see if we have any questions here. So if you're watching this, wherever you're watching, you can actually, let's see this, hold on, let me see quickly. All right, guys, so you can leave your comments on the comments field and then we can take it up again. Like I said, if you're leaving a question on Facebook, you can leave your comments, we can see that. But if you are watching from, if you are watching on YouTube and you left a question, I'm going to try to take the question as well, and then we'll see what's going on. So guys, so that's, you see, I mean, those of you who joined us today, I mean, happy you guys are making money already with us, which is great. So so that's it, guys. So this is, you want to trade with caution. You don't want to go and trade based on emotions. This is not the market for emotions. You want to know what you're doing. You want to go in on the trade, and then you want to be sure that exactly you're in the right place at the right time. Again, as you know, like I said before, it's not about the frequency of the trade, but the quality of the trade. So guys, make sure to join us every day from now on at 7 a.m. Eastern Standard Time to 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. That's when we analyze the market. We'll take a deep dive on across all the markets, showing you what's working, what's not working. It's not about being emotional. You want to be sure that you're in the right trade at the right time. And once you go in on that trade, you want to be sure that at least that trade is 80-90% in your favor, guys, in your favor. So if you have questions now, please join. There's a bot. You can click the link below this video to join our executive chat room. That's where we'll get to manage those trades. So any trade that is maturing, we'll let you know these trades are maturing. We'll let you know when the trade is likely to play out. And again, once we are live on the trade, we also begin to help you manage those trades. So that if you're not on your screen or you're someone who is busy and then you want to like, oh, what's happening to that pair? We'll monitor it for you and we'll let you know when to step out of that trade for now. So hopefully there's no other questions and we're all good. We'll be ending this stream in the next few minutes. So guys, so basically Bitcoin has been very consistent in terms of the plays because it's easier for us to, it's easier to trade in the futures. So we trade Bitcoin with on the futures market. So if you have, if you are living in, I mean, we use several of those exchanges. Binance, KuCoin in the US is what I use. I use KuCoin myself. Those of you who are in the US can use Binance US, or overseas, you can use Binance. You can use basically any of the exchanges that has a futures market that you prefer, and then you can trade. So for us, what happens is whenever we're giving you an entry for the crypto markets, it's almost sure to go in immediately because that market is just going your direction. You can see how we trade for us. As tricky as the market is, bringing that knowledge into cryptocurrency makes it much easier for us to trade it and be successful consistently in the market. So guys, like I said before, we do this every day. Make sure to join us. If you're watching this, this is your first time coming to meet us, to know who we are, make sure to subscribe to our channel and hit the notification button. We do this every day, 7 a.m. to 8 a.m. Eastern Time. Bearing any questions, there's nothing else we have to cover, and then we'll take that again, guys. So again, my name is Jeff with No Limit Markets. Thank you for watching this. Hope to see you guys tomorrow. Thank you guys, and bye for now, guys.